Critics of this year's New Year Honours list have hit out at Theresa May for using the accolades to reward MPs. Fierce backlash also came amid claims heroes who saved lives in a number of UK terror attacks and the Grenfell Tower blaze missed out. The Prime Minister has been accused of having doled out political favours to cronies, as the likes of Graham Brady, regarded as the voice of the party's backbenches at Westminster, has been awarded a knighthood. Two other members of the 1922 Committee executive are also honoured, with Vice Chairwoman Cheryl Gillan being made a dame while Treasurer Geoffrey Clifton Brown is knighted. Barry Gibb, who has been awarded a knighthood for services to and charity. Ringo Starr, who has been awarded a knighthood for services to. Former ballerina Darcy Bustle, who is being made a dame for services to dance. Alexandra Shulman, who has been awarded an CBE for services to fashion journalism. Elections expert Professor John Curtis, who said he was surprised and humbled to be given a knighthood. David Blakey, the outgoing holder of the Black Rod parliamentary post, has been made a commander of the Royal Victorian Order, RVO. Eamon Holmes, who has been awarded an OBE for services to broadcasting. Dr. Michelle Doherty, who has been Hugh Laurie, has been awarded an CBE for services to drama. Britain's first astronaut Helen Sharman, who is being made a dame. Sam Warburton, who has been awarded an OBE for services to rugby union. Darcy Bustle, who is being made a dame for services to dance. Nick Clegg, who is being awarded a knighthood in the New Year Honours list. Celebrity chef Rick Stein, who has been awarded a CBE for services to the economy. Lord Lieutenant of Greater London Ken Olissa, who received a knighthood for services to business and philanthropy. Lynn Franks, who has been awarded an OBE for services to business, fashion and women's empowerment. The Bee Gees from Left Brothers Robin, Maurice and Barry Gibb. Barry Gibb has been awarded a knighthood for services to Liberal Democrats Deputy Leader Joe Swinson, who has been awarded an CBE. Ringo Starr, who has been awarded a knighthood for services to author Jilly Cooper, who has been awarded an CBE for services to literature and charity. Wiley aka Richard Cowie JNR, who has been awarded an MBE for services to author and playwright Michael Moore Pergo, who has been awarded a knighthood for services to literature and charity. All three backed the Leave campaign in the Brexit vote, as did a fourth Conservative MP to be honoured, veteran former Minister Christopher Chope, who receives a knighthood. There are no honours for those involved in the response to recent terror attacks or the Grenfell Tower fire, which left 71 people dead. But the Cabinet Office said they are expected to be recognised in future honour lists. Labour MP Jack Dromey tweeted, "At Theresa-May hands out honours to cronies but not one of the heroes of. I suppose it's a relief to see any leavers on the list. The reason it's a surprise to see leavers on the list is previously there haven't been any. Theresa May has come under fire, EPA, but I don't think it's a reward for Brexit, but a reward for work to the party. The government's priority is keeping the party together." Asked if he would want to be included in a future honours list, MEP Mr. Farage replied, "It's never been an aspiration for me but an aspiration for many who support me. What will be. The Duchess of Cambridge, Prince William, Duke of Cambridge and Prince Harry attend the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service held at St. Paul's Cathedral. Mourners leave after attending the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. Adele teary-eyed and emotional sitting next to Marcus Mumford and Carey Mulligan during the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. Maria Jafari, bereaved daughter, speaking at Grenfell Tower Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. Mourners hold white roses at the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. Prince Harry, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, the Duchess of Cornwall and the Prince of Wales attend the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. A banner at Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral in London. To mark the six-month anniversary of the Grenfell Tower fire, mourners arrive at St. Paul's Cathedral for a Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service. Firefighters arriving for the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral in London. To mark the six-month anniversary of the Grenfell Tower fire, guests arriving at Grenfell Tower Memorial at St. Paul's Cathedral. Jeremy Corbyn and Diane Abbott arriving. Prince Harry, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, the Duchess of Cornwall and the Prince of Wales attend the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. A woman appears emotional as she leaves the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral in London. To mark the six-month anniversary of the Grenfell Tower fire, people hold photos and flowers as they leave after the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. People gather on the steps after the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral in London. To mark the six-month anniversary of the Grenfell Tower fire, people hold photos and flowers as they leave after the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. The Duchess of Cambridge leaves St. Paul's Cathedral after a memorial service in honor of the victims of the Grenfell Tower fire. Adele leaves St. Paul's Cathedral after a memorial service in honor of the victims of the Grenfell Tower fire. The Duke and Duchess, left, of Cambridge and Prince Harry, second left, attend the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral in London. To mark the six-month anniversary of the Grenfell Tower fire, Theresa May arriving at Grenfell Tower Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. Sir Martin Moorbeck, chairman of the Grenfell Public Inquiry, arrives at Grenfell Tower Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. Former footballer Les Ferdinand arrives. Mourners arrive at St. Paul's Cathedral for a Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge and Prince Harry, behind, attend the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral. The Duchess of Cambridge arrives armed policewoman at Grenfell Tower Memorial at St. Paul's Cathedral. People arriving for the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service at St. Paul's Cathedral in London. To mark the six-month anniversary of the Grenfell Tower fire, guests arriving at Grenfell Tower Memorial at St. Paul's Cathedral. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge and Prince Harry arrive at St. Paul's Cathedral for a memorial service in honor of the victims of the Grenfell Tower fire. Mourners arrive at St. Paul's Cathedral for a memorial service in honor of the victims of the Grenfell Tower fire. Grenfell survivors and bereaved family members attend the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service held at St. Paul's Cathedral. Prince Charles, Prince of Wales, arrives at St. Paul's Cathedral for a Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service. Mourners arrive at St. Paul's Cathedral for a memorial service in honor of the victims of the Grenfell Tower fire. Jeremy Corbyn with a mourner at the Grenfell Tower Memorial at St. Paul's Cathedral. Members of the public gather outside St. Paul's Cathedral ahead of the Grenfell Tower National Memorial Service. Sir Geoffrey, MP for the Cotswolds, said he believed it was completely coincidental when asked if Brexit had influenced any of the honours. He praised Sir Graham for his great job leading the 1922 committee and Dame Cheryl for her work since becoming an MP in 1992. Sir Geoffrey said it was great to be recognized for working on behalf of his community, adding, "My daughter is about to have a baby, so we've got a double family celebration." Sir Graham said, "I am delighted. It's a huge honor. My family are thrilled." SNP Cabinet Office spokesman Tommy Shepherd said public honors should recognize the remarkable efforts and achievements of people in communities which advance society. Additional reporting by Press Association.